lock up on that unison thing. And then this lick. Poor boys and pilgrims with families, we are
going to Graceland. Dude, I'll keep this super quick because it is super cold out here. Look, Ian filmed this lesson and he forgot to mention that there is an awesome download that we've put together for you guys. So if you do want the tab and notation for all of the stuff that you're about to watch, make sure that you click the link down there in the description and you'll be able to get it completely free. Anyway, Ian, over to you.
I am Ian Martin Allison with SBL, bringing you another episode of Bass Albums That Changed Music. Today, we're looking at one of my favorite records of all time, Paul Simon's 1986 release, Graceland, featuring the incredible bass playing and fretless bass playing of Mr. Bakithi Kumalo. Come on, you know you've always wanted to figure out how to do that bass break on You Can Call Me Al. Today, I'm gonna show you how to do it. Let's go. There is so much that can be said and has been said about this record, right? It came out in 1986. Paul Simon went to South Africa during apartheid to work with these South African musicians and bring a whole new sound to pop music. And while there are a few other bass players that contributed to Graceland, Alfonso Johnson, Lloyd Leosa, and Conrad Lozano, I am going to focus primarily on the bass playing of Bakithi Kumalo from the record and a little bit of his live playing as well. And let's talk gear for just a second. I'm using my trusty 80s Ibanez Musician fretless. I'm also going to play a Spector NS2 today, and I have just a couple of effects running. I'm compressing pretty hard with an Origin Effects Cali 76. I'm running just a touch of chorus and a touch of reverb in a Line 6 HX Stomp. Let's get into it. First up is Boy in the Bubble, and the thing to pay attention to on this song is Bakithi's seamless transition between sort of playing a featured part with these octave slides and then just like laying back in the groove. Check this out. Gets to that A. And then listen to him play this verse. And it swept across the desert and it curled into the circle of birth. Let's break down this part. It's so cool. He starts out that post-chorus with this slide, octave slides. And then the verse. Such a neat sound. And what I'm doing is I'm actually blending back a bit to that bridge pickup to get that kind of like barky, like nasal mid-focused sound. But I love how he uses these octaves to play this part. Next up is the title track, Graceland. And this is such a cool juxtaposition of like South African musicians playing what Paul Simon describes as like a traveling beat, like an American country beat. And he said it was so cool to see these South African musicians interpret that through their lens. It gives us Graceland. This is one of my favorite tunes on the whole record. On the highway through the cradle of the Civil War. Now listen to Bakithi play this chorus. So cool. Lock up on that unison thing. And then this lick. Poor boys and pilgrims with families, we are going to Graceland. That's one that really deserves to be broken down, okay? So here we go. Key E, Bakithi plays this in the chorus. Notice when he plays his vibrato on this G, it's not crazy and it's not side to side. It's pretty subtle. Mm-hmm. Next up is I Know What I Know, and Bakithi is actually playing a fretted bass on this, a 1985 Fender Jazz Bass Special in Burgundy Mist. I love this bass. Check this out. Now, you hear that and you think like, oh, I mean, yeah, that's a cool bass line, but that doesn't seem too hard. Man, this one has taken me a long time to get together because the octave voice on the top leads the bottom. So you play the octave voice on the top first, and this happens a bit with Bakithi's playing. So he's playing. So every note leads, it's like this. And then the octave underneath follows. And I love parts like that. They're so intentional and groovy, and man, it's like a finger twister. It's really hard to get that right. Check that thing out. Next up, Diamonds on the Soles of Her Shoes, one of my favorite songs and bass lines of all time. Listen to Bakithi play this verse groove, and then listen to this interplay with Paul's falsetto vocal. It's magic.
She said you've taken me for granted because I please you. Where it is diamonds.
How he responds to the vocal here. Here, let's break this bass line down. I need to show you both parts because it's really worth checking this thing out. So I'm blended back toward the bridge, right? And what he's doing there is he's playing this octave figure on F and then playing a 10th, which is just the third up an octave. And then even when he goes to the 5, the C, he still keeps that A, that upper 10th, the third of F, in the top part. So that top part, blah, that A, never changes. And then here's the lick. Diamonds on the Soles of Her Shoes. One of the best bass performances of all time, in my opinion. Check it out. Next up is You Can Call Me Al. I mean, do you remember the video with Chevy Chase? Legendary. This is a tune where Bakithi is slapping his fretless, and there is that incredible bass break in the middle. But before we get to the bass break, let's check out this verse.
Who'll be my role model now that my role model is gone? You duck back down the alley with some roly-poly little bat-faced girl. All along, along, there were incidents and accidents. There were hints and allegations.
So when Bakithi's slapping that, he's actually bouncing. This kind of thing. So what I do is I double thumb that, like down, up, down. It doesn't sound like Bakithi, but it's a way I can get it. And I mean, look, when you're dealing with his bass playing, you gotta do what you gotta do to make it happen, man. I mean, this dude is an animal. And if you've never tried the double thumb thing before, all it is you're going down with the thumb and then you're changing the angle slightly and going up to get that upstroke. And it lets you play this at the correct speed. All right, now the moment we've all been waiting for, right, is how to approach that amazing bass break right in the middle of the tune. Okay, I'm gonna play it for you on the record first and talk to you about what's going on, and then I'll show you how he approaches it live, and then I will show you how I approach it, okay? So, here it is from the record. For the longest time I was like, what is happening? It is so strange and wonderful. And what happens is the first half of the riff is played, and then the second half of the riff, the engineer flipped the tape and played it backwards. So it's a mirror image of itself, right? But then, of course, Bakithi learned it and plays it live this way. And the crowd goes wild. Let me show you how I approach this thing. It's such a beast to play, but so much fun and like a reward when you execute it correctly. So up to speed. Yeah, to the best of my ability. Let's slow that thing down. So the whole thing is slapped hammer-ons. There it is, slow. But those double hits at the end, it's just too fast for me to do downs. So I do the down up thing. And I mean, man, what a line. Next up is Under African Skies, a duet with Miriam Makeba. Just a lovely song. And listen to Bakithi's support in the verse and then dig into a little bit of flash, slapping a little bit in the chorus. So cool.
His path was marked by the stars in the southern hemisphere.
This part in the verse.
And he walked his days under African skies.
Then this.
This is the swift how we begin to remember.
So he's playing. But here, let's slow that thing down. So cool. So all that is I'm playing E flat here. And really a note, a pop, a short pop, and then two dead notes. And then a pop again. And this song is slow enough that I don't have to double thumb. Ooh, and that does not feel good to me. So I can get the double strike, not double thumb, not up down, in at this tempo. Next up is Crazy Love Volume 2, which features this beautiful, dynamic, fretless ostinato. Come here. You know what an ostinato is? It's just a repeating phrase. It's a fancy word for a phrase that repeats. And this is a really good one. Check out Bakithi's playing on this and then we'll break it down.
About this, and I have no opinion about that.
Listen to him vibrato that G.
Sad as a lonely little wrinkled balloon. He said, well, I don't claim to be happy about this, boys. And I don't seem to be.
So here's the line, and then I'll slow it down. So a few things going on here. We're playing a G, G triad, just a G 1-3-5 octave. What does that mean? All I'm doing is I'm playing a G, I'm playing its third, like if you have a G major scale, right? Sneaky little bass lesson that you're getting here at the end of the video. Right, if you count the degrees of a scale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, you have the 1, the 3, the 5, and the 8, which is the same as 1. So, and what a great melody this makes. And then a little vibrato on that top G. And now this is just going to the 2 chord. So here's the 2, and then that makes a minor chord. So we have an A and a C and an E. So it's just a G triad up, and then an A minor triad down. And then we just play the 5 chord, which is a D, and that's just playing. What a great bass line. And notice too, it's not all one dynamic, right? It starts kind of soft and then gets increasingly louder as you get to that top note, right? It's not this, or it's not this, right? So it's like the high notes are the loudest and then the low notes are quieter on both of the triads. If you don't know this album, just treat yourself. It is so much fun to listen to. And then the bass playing, even though it is incredibly difficult and demanding, is also so much fun. So I hope now that you've watched this, you have an idea of how to approach the fretless mastery of Bakithi Kumalo on Paul Simon's Graceland record. And look, you know what you gotta do. You gotta go down there and turn on the bell. You gotta subscribe. You gotta leave a comment. Did I miss anything? What would you like to be explained more? Are there any other fretless players or bass players in general that you would love to see? Thank you so much for watching. Again, I have been Ian Martin Allison for SBL, and I'll see you in the shed.